show us how to turn horseshoes into a rustic coat rack. Like this one right here is Paige. And Lindy and Wes decided to hang around since, you know, under the autumn moon, you kind of working around horses.
Yeah.
So you guys know a thing or two about this. Yes, we did this for you.
Thank you. Yes. Well, you know, we thought we could kind of live vicariously through you it's on our fall bucket list to ride under the autumn moon. And so I'm just going to say that I did with you guys. For the movie.
There you go.
If I watch it this Saturday night, that means I basically did it.
Basically did it. Yeah.
Okay, but I also grabbed some inspiration. Look at this. I mean, it looks so authentic. It's like you guys live on the farm there.
He wears that hat well.
You do.
Thank you.
Yes. Good on that horse.
Yes. So I actually took that horse that you were riding.
Right.
And he gave me his shoes for today's project.
Well, that was so nice of him.
He's Canadian.
Great. So he's a giver. No, that actually did not happen.
Besides the shoes, what else do we need?
We also need a board. I got a 2x12 board here. But we also need a vise. This is going to be very important. And a pipe wrench. This is normally what you would use on your pipes if you were doing work around your house in your kitchen or under your sink. Okay. And then we have hot glue, nails, hammer, and the rope and paint. I just did a little whitewash over it just to kind of make it look rustic. And then this is actual rope and hot glue.
Wow.
So, and we're going to make, it says Elkham right now. It's going
to
say
show you.
Welcome.
Yeah.
Yes.
Get it.
Yes.
Okay. I have a question as a city girl. Where does one get horseshoes?
If it weren't in under the autumn moon?
If it weren't under the autumn moon.
Okay. So
where would you get them?
You can get horseshoes online. If you do get them online, make sure that they're not craft ones. They're 3 inches high if they're craft ones. They're this tiny.
Yeah,
you're not going to hang much on that.
No.
And they're not made out of true steel. So you want to make sure you get really authentic ones. You can get them online, or you can go to a feed and tack store in your neighborhood. Or your neighborhood feed and tack store. Equestrian center.
We do.
So here's another question.
The equestrian center didn't sell them.
For my chickens.
Really?
Really?
Oh, but you could probably sweet talk them. But they didn't sell them, no.
Oh,
they sent us down.
Interesting. I'd have thought that equestrian center would have horseshoes. Once you have the horseshoes.
Yes.
How does one bend the horseshoes? Because I've seen in
movies. With my mind.
Yeah, I've seen movies where they take the heat and they bend them.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah, but I thought that would be kind of scary.
Probably.
Even though that sounds kind of fun.
Yes.
Okay, so you take this that's normally used for plumbing.
Right.
And you use this vise. So you can see that I've put a horseshoe all the way in. You always want to, I learned, have a horseshoe facing up if you're putting it on a wall. Because it's good luck.
It's good luck.
You don't want to tip it because the luck will go off.
The luck runs out. Yeah.
Yep. Really?
That's how they do it.
How did she know that?
I just know things.
She knows things.
Things.
She learned that on the set of Under the Moon.
I'm really superstitious. Yes, me too.
So I know those things. So it's only you going, always have them up. So the luck stays
so you use the pipe wrench, and all you're going to do is put it in the vise and then pull down.
Whoa.
That's it.
Oh my gosh, you just did that.
You look
I know.
So tough.
Don't I?
That's a very
It's my large
Paige.
Muscles.
Yeah, you do. You look really tough doing that.
Wow. And that's it.
Okay.
And that's all you need to bend it. And if you can look at the one behind Wes there, you can see that it just needs to be bent a tiny little bit for you to be able to hang your scarf or your hat or your jacket off of.
Now, you did this, Wes, but you had a different technique in the movie.
We did. Well, the guy that we used, he made his own, and you churned a fan that lit charcoal.
Oh my gosh.
Right, see,
stayed lit, and it was steaming hot.
Wow.
And he made it. It was.
You did that?
It's very cool to watch.
You did that?
I did.
I think we have a picture of you doing that.
Yeah, we just saw that.
Because I attempted that without the heat. It didn't go well for me.
It was too hard, huh?
No, I tried to do a hammer. Didn't work.
Yeah, that's when it's red hot right there.
Okay, so we have our horseshoes that are bent. How do we? I don't think hot glue is going to secure these to the.
No, but I did. I kind of cheated and I used hot glue to set it in place because these are actual horseshoe nails that come with horseshoes.
What?
Yes, if you turn it over, you can see there's a groove.
Yeah.
And the nails actually go inside of that and then they grind them off for the horse. But I'm going to hide that side and we're going to put it right there. Because I used a 2x12, I went in an inch from the bottom and an inch and 3/4 from the side. Mm-hmm. You guys can do whatever you want at home. And I'm just gonna add a little glue just to hold it in place.
And then you're gonna nail
while
it.
While I nail it, yes. And I mean, Wes, because you were so darn
this is
good.
Be cool. I can't wait to see this.
I think I might have Wes.
Wes,
am I doing this?
Yes, can you?
You don't wanna give it a shot?
I'm good.
Okay.
Let's put one in there.
She's
one
gonna
in
make
there.
Kitty noises.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, just make kitty noises.
It's so cute!
There we go.
That's very
good.
Nice.
That's really good.
And we get the special nails with the
Well
shoes.
Done,
yes.
Wes.
Okay.
A few more.
Yeah, right. If you could please. We're going to put you to work.
Yeah.
We feed
I'm here
you
to work.
And put you to work. Very nice.
There we go.
Oh,
That's it. There you go.
I could have used
you. Yay!
Yes. Well done. Thank you. Very nice.
Impressive.
Yes. Where were you during the rest of all of them?
Now we have to finish the welcome, so
yes.
It doesn't say elkum.
Yes, we needed to say welcome. And what I did, and if you can zoom in real close here, you might be able to see my little scratch marks here. I freehanded welcome. If you don't feel good freehanding it, you can use stencils. But what I suggest is using script, because this is one long piece of rope, of the twine, and then the W is going to be separate. But if you were trying to separate every single letter, it would take you a long time.
All right.
So all you do is put the glue kind of around where the letter goes.
Be careful, because hot glue is
careful.
Hot.
It is hot. Yes, all of us crafters know. I should have used those things that Orly came up with.
Oh, right, that she invented because I burned myself in every segment. Anytime I get close to the gun, I don't even literally touch it. I'll reach across and it burns me.
Yeah.
The gun does not like me.
Yes. It doesn't
dangerous.
Like many people.
Yeah.
Okay, so then you take it back down and we're going to squeeze that together. It does stay hot for a little bit.
That.
You can also use a low temperature to make sure if you're really touching these a lot.
All right.
And then.
Look at that, Paigey.
Beautiful.
And then we just need to
it's
cut
adorable.
That little guy off. Could you,
do you think
could you
do
grab
that?
I'm going to hold this in place. There,
nope,
keep going, keep going.
There you go.
Oh, guys.
There you go. Well done. You deserve a round of applause as well.
Harder than it looks.
If Wes got applause, you deserve
harder than it looks.
Now the stars.
Now the stars. Okay, these are just regular. I am full of this glue. These are just regular little stars you can find on the internet. These are tin. I'm going to give that to you. Careful.
That's very cute.
Okay.
There you go.
Lindy's going to do that side. I will do this side, and we...
Are
together, we'll have a completed masterpiece.
I love this.
There
it's really cute, Paige.
It's really
this is
cute.
Beautiful.
I love it.
So how did you hang this? Because this is heavy.
I would suggest using a French cleat.
Okay.
Because then that really locks it in. And no matter, you know, if you have kids or boys, sorry, Wes.
It's fine.
They're typically a little harder. So
things.
If you hang something here, you want to make sure that it's going to stay, even if you give it
sure,
a tug.
Sure, if you give it a tug.
Yep.
Now we have officially checked number 10 off
yes.
our fall harvest bucket list.
Yes.
That's
it. Ride horses under the autumn moon. And I'm living vicariously.
And I think we one-upped it with the stars of under the autumn moon.
Oh, very nice.
Now, we deserve the round of applause. For the full instructions, visit our website. And don't forget to watch the premiere of Under the Autumn Moon this Saturday, October 13th at 9/8 Central, right here on Hallmark Channel. And